today in Melbourne, and I have a pleasure to be with Jacques Reymond.
How are you?
So, Jacques, I'm going to ask you some questions about you.
Sure.
So you are a successful chef, a restaurateur, and a consultant. So my question is that I know that you have French origins and you started in your family hotel back in France.
Yeah.
And tell me about your steps in career.
I started, I was very young with my father in the kitchen, and when I was 16 I went to the hotel school in Nice for 2 years, then I became a professional, so I went to work in England and then back in France in a 3-star Michelin, then into a 2-star Michelin, and then I went to Brazil with my wife for 3 years, then we came back in Europe and went to Spain and then Paris and then my village where we obtained a Michelin star, and came to Australia 32 years ago.
So start the career in international one.
Whatever you want to say, I mean, you know, it's the advantage of our industry that you can travel and find a job everywhere you want.
Yeah, it's true.
So is good.
Tell me something about your philosophy and cooking style.
Yeah, well, my cooking style is very personal. It's based on the French technique, but not the French cuisine. You never got French cuisine. We have a very strong Asian influence. We don't use stock, we don't use powder, we don't use cream, we don't make any reduction. It's mainly the quality of the product by itself, and we don't touch the product. It expresses itself through its own characteristic. This is our philosophy.
Yeah, so good and very genuine as well.
And very, you know, tasty and respectful to the product.
Artistic also. Yeah. Nice. So right now we are at Hotel Chicago. That's a new venture of you. And so tell me something about this. It's very interesting. You just opened.
Yeah, we opened this establishment in December, so it's now just over two months. Since we opened, we've been about 100 for lunch and 200 people for dinner every day. So it's very popular. We start cooking in the morning at 9 o'clock in the morning, and we don't finish until about 11 at night. It's all day long. It's very interesting, it's a new concept. So I think we've been very, very creative and very contemporary in our offering by saying that, and the people can come anytime in the day and have something to eat with us.
Okay, so it looks like to be a feast all day.
One is not a feast all day, because not everyone has a big meal all day, but
okay.
It's cooking all day, yes.
Yeah. So I know that Jacques, you fall in love with some ingredients that you love for cooking. Which are they and why do you like?
Oh look, it's mainly all the Asian fragrances, which are first discovered in Brazil, and then pursued my interest once I came to Australia. So all the wonderful fragrances which enables me to do my style of cuisine, which are like lemongrass, cajun leaf, galangal, chili, ginger, all these sort of wonderful fragrances.
So you said once that fusion is not confusion. What do you mean with this?
Well, I mean that, you know, 90% of the chefs try to mix different ethnic communities, cuisine, and as well different ingredients. Don't do it twice,
right,
there is no harmony. There is no harmony.
Sorry.
Hey, shush, guys, please. You. So they create more, you know, a confusion than making a beautiful dish altogether. Most of them will put far too many ingredients, and combination will not work together. So this is why I say, you know, if you do a cooking machine, use a fusion by getting some influence from another culture, another technique, or another cuisine, though based on what you like to do, then make sure it's right. Make sure that you think thoroughly through it, and then the result is a fantastic, fantastic dish.
Okay, that's I think it's very contemporary thinking.
Yeah, it is contemporary.
Yeah, very open that. That's what we like as well. So, Jacques, you also have been on TV. What is your experience on TV programs?
Well, TV is very, very time consuming. I did a couple of series, like with the ABC and the SBS. One was a very long, was 13 series. It lasted for 6 months. I did find that it was very interesting and it was quite challenging. But if you are an owner operator like me, it can be dangerous because it does damage your business because you're not in your establishment.
Yeah.
You're always traveling, you're always filming. And it makes it difficult.
Was it a good experience?
It was fantastic, yeah, it was great. And we had every episode, we had 1.5 million views. So that was very successful.
So, ask you another question. So, this is a new venture, if you are attention down. Which are your new ideas for projects for the future?
We have another establishment on the line which we should open about 2.5 years, so this will be by the beach, so that will be very interesting as well. Not a different concept, but still keeping the same base that we have at the Bistro Gitan and Hotel Gitan, in terms of our cuisine inspiration. What else I will do, I don't know. I'm a man who doesn't like to plan too much ahead. I get about 6 to 8 offers on a daily basis of consultancy, of new venture, or whatever, of association. But I want to stay with my family first of all, and keep working with them, which has given me a great pleasure and great success too.
Okay, so good luck with new ventures.
Thank you. There is always been plenty of activities, trust me.
How you say good luck in French?
Bonne chance.
Bonne chance, okay, bonne chance. Bye-bye.
Thank you.